Well, hey there. I'm just sitting here pondering the meaning of fishing, my fishing in particular. I have to say it's probably been one of the worst seasons I've ever had. So much to my wife's disgust, I've decided to wear my lucky fishing t-shirt for a whole week. And hopefully, a bit of the mojo will ooze back into the soul and change my luck around a little bit. Not that I'm a superstitious man, but I once went fishing with two mates and one pulled out a banana. And the other mate just packed up and wouldn't fish anymore, because apparently you don't bring bananas on a fishing trip. Who knew? But I digress. This isn't going to be a video about bananas. This is going to be a video about this little here, a piece of what I assume is 5160 or leaf spring that I found while I was fumbling around down in the river. And I thought, I chucked it in my vest, brought it home, and I think I'll try and make a couple of knives out of it. So what are we working with? We're working with about 400 long, just under 50 wide. So my first impression was maybe I'd make a kitchen knife, but I like to tend to keep them a lot wider than I can get out of this. So I don't know about that. The other option is I can make one of these carving knives, but it seems to be a little bit of offcut, unnecessary. So maybe not, maybe yes. We'll have to wait and see. The other options I was thinking of, this little design here, which I've never tried before. I call that my ceremonial box opener. Place that on there. I'll get one of those and stick to the classic 4-inch bushcraft. I think that'll fit. Maybe not, maybe yes. But anyway, those are some ideas, so we'll see what comes out of that. What I want to do, the plan is, to try and keep as much of the rustic charm as we can and preserve a little bit of history, I guess, is one way of putting it. So, what to do next? We'll throw it in the vial brew, try and get rid of most of the rust, and see what comes up. So if that sounds like something you might be interested in watching, saddle up and come along for the ride. This here being the said vial brew. Nothing too sinister, it's just cider vinegar, to be fair. So we'll chuck it in there for a couple of 3 days. Let it do its magic and see what we've got to work with. Righto, it's been in the vial brew for a couple of 3 days. Let's grab it out, have a scrub up. See what we're working with. Yuck, there it is. Right. Big reveal. A little bit more damage than I thought. Quite pitted. Most of the stuff's come off. Not quite as good as I'd hoped. But we've got something we can work with. The rest of that we'll get. Yeah. Okay, let's go and mark some blade shapes on it and start a cutting. So now we're at the marking out a pattern stage. Had a few changes. Yeah. thinking about it, trying to fit my patterns on. It's not as much here as I thought. Don't know if you can see clearly in that video. The light's not the greatest, but never mind, we'll work with what we got. So I'm going to stick with this one. Like I said, ceremonial box opener. Going to fit that on there. 4-inch bushcraft. Yeah, a bit big, can't really fit it on. It's quite a divot there. That's a bit bigger than I thought it would be. But anyway, that is what it is. The bushcraft there is a little bit big, so we'll can that one. Going to go for this little thing too here. I don't know what it is, but it's just a pattern I had sitting in my improvised briefcase. That'll fit on. So we'll work with those two there. And then I think with what's left, I have another go at a folding knife. Another little wee pattern I've got there. So I'll mark those out on there and start a cutting out. Yeah, should be good. So we end up with three knives out of this, hopefully, all going well. And that's the plan. The sun's about to come up. So I'll get those marked. When the sun's up, we will proceed with the old cutout. Here goes. As with all my knives, custom made as it were, they evolve as they go. So they make them out a little different. But we'll see what happens as we proceed. So I don't know how well you can see those marks. Don't even know if you can see them at all, but I've got enough to go to for cutting. I'll just roughly do that and then remark them again, of course, and we'll start a shaping and cutting them out. Dirty old river find. Let's go. Yeah. So yeah, what you saw me doing there is roughing out the basic shape, just cutting them out. And from here, I'll go and remark them and go to the 2x72 and finish off shaping the profile of them that way. What you also saw me do is stick them in the dirty old forge, the old DIY with the frosty tea burner in it. Yeah, you might have noted it spluttered around a bit. There could be a couple of reasons for that. A little bit of moisture in it perhaps. Should have really let it warm up first. And we're getting a bit low on gas. But at the moment, I've only got about $2 left in my coppers, so you just got to make do with what you got. But that's all good. We got there. We got them annealed. I've just given them a bit of an anneal, soften them up a bit so I can drill my holes. And you'll note that they have a bit of a bend in them, which is normally the case because they were, well, it was once an old car spring, probably off a 4x4. The old car springs tend to have a bit of memory in them. They like to be curved. They don't like to be straight. So you tend to get a bit of distortion. Sometimes you've got to be a little careful with it. So I've got them a little bit softer. So now we'll go and give them a straighten up and we'll work on proceeding with our profiling. So I'd have to say probably the scariest thing I do in knife making for me is straightening up blades, especially when I've hardened and tempered them. I probably would have made 50, 60, I don't know, maybe more blades last year. And yeah, blades like this in particular, dirty old bushcraft, probably got about 6 or 7 sitting in a box here somewhere. But this one here came out with a bit of a curve. It's been hardened, it's been tempered. And yeah, another example. This one here, same thing, got a curve in it. Like I say, I probably made 60, 70 knives last year. These two are the ones that came out bent. They've been hardened, they've been tempered. I don't want to ruin that. And yeah, one day I may do a little video about straightening them with the flame, but trying to straighten that, got to be a little bit careful. When I pluck up the courage to give that a go, I might make a video of it. I've broken a couple of blades. Once I get to that far, because what I'll do, I'll put them in this here, use this little jig with the round bars in it, and straighten them with a bit of heat. Yeah, the ones I did break was my own fault. I was got them too cold once they'd been hardened and tempered. And yeah, enough said on that. So I'm just going to give these a little bit of a straighten now. Like I say, they've been annealed, so they're reasonably soft. So all I'm just going to do is put them in the vise and do them by hand. That shouldn't take too much. These ones here, I'm not too worried if they're 100% straight, because it all adds to the rustic charm of what they are and where they came from. But we'll get them as good as we can. Nah, bit of a curve. And like I said, due to the fact they're spring steel, they want to be bent. Seem to have a memory sometimes, so I'll keep working through the whole process to keep this bend out of them. And put them in that little vise. If you saw my video, or I don't know which one it was now, but I have a video of a little vise. I might show that too when I harden these. I take it straight out of the harden and clamp them in between two bits of steel. It just helps when they cool down to keep them straight. Not too shabby. Haven't got my ruler anymore, but there you go, you get the essence. So far so good. We should still be able to get 3 knives out of this. You got to be a little careful on the ends because they bend a little bit easier. Bit of rain on the roof. I don't know if you can hear that. Hopefully it's not interfering with things. Oh, too far. What you also saw me do is just remove the burrs. Remove the burrs on the edge. Oh, it's not too bad now, actually. Remove the burrs because they get, if I don't remove the burrs like that, it'll get caught up in the 2x72 and make a bit of a mess. That's my little folding knife, it'll be. That's the little wee EDC. I'm just going to eyeball these for the minute. Good enough. Not bad, actually. Rightio, from there, we'll continue with our profiling and shape the blades. I will probably profile them out. They're looking a bit ratty, but that's what I want. Profile them out, and then I'll harden and temper them. And then we'll do the blade actual bevels. Alrighty. Let's move on. Right, not really sure what we're up to in the video, can't remember, but pretty sure we've done the rough shaping, that one there. It's come up not too bad actually, if you saw that little vise that I, what do you call it, rattle gun it down onto, straight out of the heat, quench it, and put it in there and keep it straight. These have come up pretty good, pretty happy with that. Yeah, you don't want to be straightening anything when it gets under about 200, I think, from memory. Then you're getting into some dangerous territory. So there's a harden, we've done that. These are hard as a coffin nail. I've skated a file on them, and yeah, they're pretty much where I want them to be. So what I'm going to do now is chuck them in the old benchtop oven, because that's all I've got. Would I harden them or temper them in a forge like that? Harden, I mean, if I had a heat treating oven? No, probably wouldn't. But this is all I got, so this is what I do, and it tends to work. One thing I will note, which I've noted in other videos, but I'll say it again. Oh, I nearly fell over. The dial on this thing here is not very accurate. So I've got myself one of these. Yep, it's just an oven thermometer. I'm going to do two cycles of this, two-hour cycles. And I think I'm aiming for about 195 degrees C. So I'm not exactly sure what that'd be Fahrenheit, but conversion charts are good. So I'm going to stick these in there for a couple of hours, and then we'll get back to shaping the bevels. I'll get that there. You might note too that we have moved apart from the folding knife due to the fact it'll be a huge amount of work. A lot of hand filing, so I didn't harden that at the moment. I'll have to hand file that up and work on the tuning and do all the bits and pieces you have to do with the folding knife, so that'll be another video. So we'll part ways here and work on these two. See how far we get. So yeah, it's probably going to be a bit of a long video, but it is what it is, because this is the process we're using. So that's the basic bevels ground on, as good as I can do. That's what you've been watching anyway. So this here, one thing I noted when I'm looking at it again, is this piece here. You can see on the other side, you can see how that's gone right up to the top. If this was a knife I was going to sell, then I would probably try and chase that up. But the problem I'm going to get if I do that, due to the bits, pits and the divots and all the rest of it, the problem I'm going to get, if I can get that thing, I would get a notch in there if I chase that right up. So for what I'm going to do with these, just have them as my River Find collection. I'm pretty happy with them so far. Pretty similar on this one too. It's quite a bit of pitting and stuff over here, or on the other side there really wasn't as much. But anyway, that's what it is. I'm pretty happy, like I said, with what's going on. So now we're going to do an epic hand sand. Bring them up to about 400 maybe. See how they look there, and then I'm not going to put handles on them actually. I'm going to use a bit of paracord, give that a go and see what they look like then. And that should bring us to the end for this part. So bear with me and carry on, and we'll get the hand sanding done and put the paracord on. And yeah, all good. We'll be right back. So if you got this far, thanks for watching, and thanks for sticking around. I'm pretty happy. You would have just seen a still of where we're up to now. And yeah, I'm pretty happy with them as they are, to be fair. But I said I'd put something on the handle, so that's exactly what I'll do. So I'm going to take this here. First ever folding knife I made. I'm just going to prep the paracord and get that done. If you want to know more about the old folding knife, have a look at the videos I put on. Yeah, hopefully you enjoy those too. So this is probably the second cut I've ever done with it. It's not actually, it's had a bit of a thrashing, but yeah. Nice and sharp, that's all good. So I'm going to try and do black and red on this one. I'm just going to prep these up and then we'll get stuck into it. I'm just going to glue these ends together, stop them fraying with, of course, with the old Zippo. Can't beat a Zippo. See how this works out. So far, so good. Haven't done a lot of paracord handles, but live and learn. Zippo won't go. Back in action, got the Zippo working again. Yep, good. Just give them a bit of a melt so they don't fray. I've had a Zippo lighter since I was about 14 years old. But there you go. Probably don't care about that. Right. So we're nearly there with that. We're nearly there with the end of the video. So I hope you've enjoyed it so far. And we'll get these handles on, like I've said, about three times. Elephant glue didn't work this time, so I'm going to try something a little Rodgy Dodge. I'll try and heat the pliers up and melt the stuff together. See how that works. Don't want to get them too hot, of course, but... It worked a wee bit better. Oh, melted my board. Never mind, it happens. So yeah, probably not the ideal practice, but it's worked, so that's good. Nice, tight, so we get that on there. No worries at all. So there you go, bit of a brief overview. I've put it on the paracord handle, battery on the camera went flat. Yeah, disc got full, everything went wrong, but we got there in the end, so that's that one done. Pardon me, and I'm pretty happy with that. It's come up pretty good. So we've got one more to go, and then we'll do an outro and some stills and stuff like that. I'm just going to do, I think these are called snake knots. I could be wrong. But I'm just going to do one or two more of these, put that on there, cut the end, and I'm pretty happy with that. I'm not really a lanyard fan, just a personal thing, but yeah, pretty happy with the way that's turned up. Hopefully that focuses. So like I say, once again, we've got one more to go. I'll show a fast forward version of that. There's plenty of videos on the internet about wrapping paracord handles. If you wanted me to go over it in more detail, of course I can make a video, but like I say, I haven't really done many of these, so there you go, just let me know in the comments. But yeah, there we are, let's get stuck into the next one and finish this all off. So that's it for now. River Find project, we've got to there. How I turned a dirty old piece of rusty leaf spring that I found in a river into the ceremonial box opener. A little EDC here. And I'll get that folding knife finished at some stage in the future. So that's a tale of three knives. And yeah, thanks for watching. And if you subscribe, that really helps me out a lot. So that's great. But just before we finish, one point I would like to make is that all the temperatures for heat treating, hardening and tempering and all the rest of it is just take that with a grain of salt. What I quote here is, yeah, what I do with the gear that I have, and that's what works for me. If you're new to knife making, you need to do your research, do some tests and find out what's best for yourself. Find your recipes, get things like this, your colour charts. And you can never do enough testing. Get some offcuts, heat treat them, test them, and do that type of thing. What I do when I make a knife for the first time, like this here, the thing with recycled spring steel is you never really know what the steel is. So I take the offcuts and I'll do some tests and get the temperatures and everything exactly what I need. And then I'll set my little benchtop oven to get it exactly where I want. So like I said, the dial on it's pretty dodgy, so really I don't know what temperature I'm getting, but after testing and that I seem to get some pretty good results. So that's one thing I will say. So on that note, enjoy the rest of your day, and I hope everybody's well.